Easy.
Krishna was one of the masters of ancient time. He was very famous, and still very famous now. And when he was young, he was very naughty. Everybody knows. Sometimes he stole meat and he ate it. And then his nurse mother approached him and said, "Why you stole my father?" He was smeared all over the place. But he said, "No, I haven't eaten anything." He was a very beautiful child, like every child. When we read something like that, we feel very comforted that the master wasn't perfect from birth, and very naughty also, like every of us. So like that, we have hope that we will one day, with all our naughtiness and haughtiness, we might also become enlightened and reach the peak of enlightenment like Krishna. That's why the Indian people love Krishna's story so much, because he's so naughty, he's so human, he's so ordinary, and he's so lovable. He's not something so high and so shining that everyone cannot reach or fear or keep distant. But he was everything of us and more. And he has everything that we have, so that we feel secure that he is one of us and we can reach what he has that we do not reach yet. He has more to offer. He has what we have, so that we feel comforted. And he has more, so that we aspire to reach what he has reached. Supposedly, Krishna was God incarnate. Yeah. And he might have been. He must have. But what he talk about in the Gita is what the master would talk about. Every master should talk the same, so similar to the Gita. Worship me and devote to me, and then you will reach the highest. It doesn't mean that he the person of that Krishna in the body, but he means the highest self, the one that is one with God, Krishna, the God self. Therefore, the me is always capitalized. And when Krishna was alive, he supposed to have done many miracles. All miracles tend to happen around him, not that he did anything on purpose. Most masters are this way. They don't do things on purpose. Things just happen by arrangement through their super conscious. And the master might or might not even aware of it. He cannot to be aware of these tribal things, because this is not the main
point.
It's not the purpose of the master coming to earth. The purpose of a master to come to any planet is to teach people the way of truth, how to know their greatness, how to realize that they are God itself, that they are one with God, that they are very special being, not just a body. And anything happen around the master, it's bound to happen, because the master is imbued with all kind of miracles, all kind of goodness, all kind of blessing, and all kind of incredible supernatural quality. And things always happen around the master, or to whomever in connection with the master, without the master having to lift a finger, or to raise a voice, or to even produce a thought in the mind. Yes. But most people tend to misunderstand thinking like the master would do miracles on purpose and things like that. Not when it's not necessary. Many people would make a lot of fuss and make more myths about the master. Actually, the master should be very lively, lovable, and just ordinary person. And things will happen around him, and also with the disciples. And only the disciples know. If they want to show it to other people, it's not possible. That's why the path of the master is inner path. Let's say it's a secret doctrine. It is only the names that left over from a true spiritual heritage from a real master when he was or she was alive. After that, they call it secret doctrine, they call it the inner path, or path of the saint, the path of the master, and all kind of things. But if without a master, no secret doctrine can ever be revealed. No path of the master can be achieved, or can be known, can be understood. Any path at all without a master is no path. It's only a map, and nobody walk on it. So the master is the one who came and show you how to walk the map, how to use the map to find the treasure that we always want to find. Without the master, the treasure will always remain hidden, even if we have the map. Yeah. Because even, you know, to any kind of treasure, the road is full of danger, full of tricks and traps to harm those seekers. Therefore, the master should be there to protect him, even though he has the map. Yes, because he doesn't know the way. So nobody is like that. Krishna was one of these masters. That's why he was worshipped, loved by thousands when he was alive. Especially the girls, because he's supposed to be very beautiful, very handsome. They call him a handsome black heartbreaker. So actually, the master is not really physically beautiful. It might not be, but people are so attracted. They cannot help just to love the master. So they just call him by all different names, the Almighty, the most beautiful, and the beloved, and the miraculous one, the world honor one, the best one, the one and only, the everything. Love makes blind, you know. Therefore, we heard all the names attributed to the master, which the master don't even dream about. But people just express their love through their language. Yeah. So Krishna is supposed to be a heartbreaker, the woman charmer, you know. He charmed thousands of them. And even in the middle of the night, when they heard that he's somewhere, they forgot to put on their makeup, and instead of mascara, they put it here, they put it there, maybe like that. And the trousers were up down, and the skirt, and the shirt down there, and they will run with hair and kim and all kind of things. They run so excited to see the master. Actually, it's all his spiritual attraction. And they say he has 16,000 wives and all that.
Yeah, they're disciples.
Yes, yes. And there are many similar stories to Krishna.